this to the market forces, anybody would come in and do a B.Ed. and get unemployed eventually. Otherwise, also unemployment, hey. Professor Ghanta was telling that there are 600,000 unemployed B.Eds in Andhra Pradesh. Do you need more B.Ed colleges? We have written to state governments, kindly give your consent in 2016-17 advertisement which programs you need. We have provided a demand supply analysis to the states. There are also questions that there is teacher eligibility test, that those who are getting into teacher education becoming graduates are not able to complete or pass a teacher eligibility test. Galati kahan hai bataiye? Where is the test itself is galat, teaching sansta galat, master ji galat, curriculum galat, jo enter kiya khud hi galat, bataiye. Sochna to padega na, you can't blame. There will be a test to get into a profession. If students are not able to pass, we have to all together reflect on that and find out what is the problem. You can't simply blame. Blame would simply mean abolish this test. This is the easiest way to do that. So therefore, friends, let us find out ways and means that how best to implement this. Any other question? Ji. Other degree minus M.Ed. M.Ed, open and distance learning, we have eliminated this time, for the time.
But among the 15 appendices, the appendix 9 is given to open distance learning, D.L.Ed. And activity 141, the plus 2 level and 2 years of school experience is there. But how can we admit the candidates if he is not a regular mode of a student?
You see, that's a very important question, by the way, friends. He has read it properly. Thank you very much. Let me explain this. Maja aaya. Padhe to sahi, maja aaya. Let me explain this. There is a serious demand for, because of RTE 2009, 2015 is the year that RTE 2009 must have been implemented. But many children are out of school. Therefore, RTE beyond 2015, whether this will be extended or not, that's a different question. But the point is that because of expansion, that many schools, primary and elementary schools, have come up. And therefore, there is a pressure that teachers are being appointed without proper training. Trained teachers are not available. Those who are available, they have not cleared the TET. Because TET is compulsory for primary and elementary. For secondary, senior secondary, TET is not yet compulsory. We are designing TET for secondary and senior secondary, but we have not made it compulsory. But it's compulsory because of RTE. NCTE is given the responsibility as nodal authority under central government that you decide the minimum qualification for teachers to be appointed also, including the special education teachers, which the Rehabilitation Council of India, we are negotiating with them. Renegotiating with them, because B.Ed special and M.Ed special education should also be 2 years duration, otherwise the equivalency cannot be established. Therefore, there are state governments who have untrained teachers already at the primary and elementary level. DL-Ed is basically primary, but we are also including elementary into that because we would like to promote a four-year integrated program, Bachelor of Elementary Education, BL-Ed, after plus two, a four-year integrated program also. We expect that the universities will start this program. So therefore, in that case, we have eliminated at the first degree because there is a state government proposal that there are untrained teachers. Now you have to decide whether you will stick to first degree and not allow them, or you allow them to become trained teachers. Choice is between these two. That you stick to your point that the first degree has to be faced, the first degree of teacher education has to face to face. That simply means these teachers would continue to teach untrained for the whole lifetime, or you allow them to get trained through open and distance learning. And look at the ODL norms today, friends, in norms and standards. The open and distance learning norms have become very strict. Very strict. We have simply said that these will be blended programs. We will develop guidelines and provide open and distance learning. We are in constant deliberation with the Distance Education Bureau, which eventually, hopefully soon, would become the Distance Education Council of India. The bill will be passed. And if it is, we will work out with them that how jointly we will address open and distance learning. We are already into negotiation with them. This is a fundamental question, of course. Any other question, friends? Ji.
With regard to the Bachelor of Elementary Education, which is a fully integrated course, the eligibility is the plus two completion candidate. Whereas BA 2 years, the eligibility degree is the BA. So here there is a 1 year duration is more in BA, whereas in the case of Bachelor of Elementary Education. So
therefore,
what to do?
What to do? The question is what to do.
Because the candidate studied 4 years after completion of the intermediate.
Let me clarify. Let me clarify. Lest this may be misinterpreted. We have worked very hard with UGC on this issue, seriously, because UGC has been party to our decision making, and therefore. The nomenclature is agreeable to them. Earlier, the old RIE BSc Ed program, let me go to the history. The old RIE BSc Ed program came through an innovative route, but it was not recognized by either NCTE or, but through an innovative route, therefore it was recognized, but it was not made as a national program. So when we went ahead to make a BA BEd or BSc BEd a national program, we had to deliberate a lot. Your question is, somebody who is putting in 3 years BSc and 2 years BEd, a 5 years, is that person equivalent to somebody who is putting in 4 years in BSc BEd integrated program? If that is the question, let me proceed. If that is the question, 100% they are equivalent by University Grants Commission. Take it for granted. They are, if you, aapko achha lag raha hai, mujhe nahin lag raha hai ki aapko achha lag raha. These BSc, let me repeat, friends, the 5 years BSc and BEd separately is equivalent to 4 years of BSc BEd integrated. Why? You will ask why? That 5 years input is given only in 4 years, not 4 years input is being given. 5 years input is given in 4 years. You will say how? You will say how? You will ask how it will be given? Please communicate properly to your friends also. That how it will be given? That UGC says a BSc of 3 years we will not negotiate. Therefore, your university and college has to teach BSc of 3 years. The education department will teach BEd of 2 years. The earlier formula of integrating them in whatever way is not acceptable. That BSc and BEd, they will continue simultaneously. These students may sit through the BSc classes of the college or university. So the BSc curriculum of UGC, your university or college must be respected. And BEd of 2 years of the education department must be respected. Am I communicating, friends?
Yes.
If there are any questions, ask right now. Your old BSc Ed program is not acceptable to us.
Now colleges are different. BEd college and the BSc college is different.
Don't start it. Who tells you? Is it compulsory for you to start that program? Am I communicating, friends? If you have a multi-campus program, a university, or a multi-comprehensive college like Uttar Pradesh, where there are different departments in the college and there is also an education department, you can start a BSc BEd or BA BEd program. If you don't, if you are a single BEd college, it is impossible for you to start. Don't think of this. Nothing is compulsory, friends. It is up to you. Puchhiye, please. A chance nahin milega. Humko nahin milega feedback ka chance. Please ask. Prayer. No, you, it's something to ask. Please, those who would like to go for prayers, please go. It is already time, please.
Sir, in the guidelines, it is stated that the state government recommendations are expected within the stipulated time. If the state government doesn't respond, the regional council, the NCT-SRC is competent to grant of recognition or not to grant.
No, state government, what state government approval?
Recommendations on a particular application is not received within the stipulated time, despite of several reminders to the state government, then the council will take action. That is mentioned here. But in your speech, you have stated that when an applicant comes for registering his application for a new course, it should be, the recommendation should be, the US recommendation should be also busted. But it is not floated in the guidelines.
You are reading a wrong document, my friend.
No.
My 2014 regulation, you are reading regulation, you are studying norms and standards.
Yes, it is in the.
Do you have regulation? If you bring to me, I will read out the lines to you. What we have said that.
Page number 94. It is also.
What is the title? What is the. लाइए मेरे पास लाइए ना नहीं 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 प्लीज बी क्विक प्लीज ब्रिंग टू मी यू माइट बी रीडिंग ए रॉन्ग पेज इधर लाइए
अदरवाइज वी आर रॉन्गली मिस्टेकन टू इंसिस्ट अपॉन द कॉलेज
वी हैव नॉट मिस्टेकन लेट मी रिपीट आई एम जस्ट ट्राइंग टू फाइंड आउट दैट लाइन माय फ्रेंड हां 5.3 कौन सा पेज 5.3 my friend, thank you very much. You have made my job. 5.3, page number 93. Let me read it very carefully for you. Please interpret it properly. We all need to become lawyers, eh? The application shall be submitted online electronically. We will not henceforth accept physical application. It has to be submitted online electronically along with the processing fee and scanned copies of required documents such as no objection certificate issued by the concerned affiliating body. And no objection certificate is a must at the time of application. That is a necessary document. If that is not there, the application will not be entertained. Is it clear, friends? That the final statement that you made, that no objection from the state government, we have increased 15 days more to 90 days because state governments were delaying. After that, read it, that we have said, good or bad, we have said that the regional concerned regional committee will examine that application on case-to-case basis. Case-to-case basis, the regional committee will define, including if at all at that stage they can still reconsider whether there is a demand for that program. That also will be included in case-to-case basis. Ab badi wahan se bulawa hai, matlab nirdesh hai, chalna hai, program khatam karna hai. Aur kuch hai to jaldi batayega. कुछ अगर ऐसा मन में है अगर मन में ये भी है कहिएगा हम इम्प्लीमेंट नहीं करेंगे ये भी बताइए कुछ तो है जो बताइए मेरी तरफ से लेट मी रिपीट हमें करना पड़ेगा अब कुछ भी रास्ता निकालिए हम भी कुछ निकाल लेंगे रास्ता तो ऐसा तो चलेगा नहीं इसको करना पड़ेगा नंबर टू दैट सिंस दिस इज द ट्रांजिशन This is the first year. This is the first time we are implementing a new thing. There will be problems. Number three, therefore, based on the problems, we should now come back after implementation that what are the problems and try to relook at. That's the best way to do that. Otherwise, regulation is a legal thing. Some people are trying that the university teaching department should be exempted from this. If the university teaching departments are exempted from this, all affiliated colleges are affiliated to university teaching departments, who would be responsible finally, by the way, friends? Thank you very much.
for the wonderful initial remarks and valuable thoughts on new regulations, norms and standards. I express my heartfelt gratitude for providing this opportunity to conduct this two-day orientation program in this Manu campus. And I'm sure that all our participants and our scholars, with their active participation, will meaning this orientation program to be very meaningful. Now, it's a high time that we have a break for the lunch. हमारी ये दुआ है कि ये जो नए प्रोग्राम के साथ आप आए हैं ये प्रोग्राम कामयाब रहें. मेरी दुआ है कि अफकार नौ की खुशबू से हर एक शेह व मुअत्तर, हर अंजुमन महके, हर कॉलेज में ये न्यू करिकुलम फ्रेमवर्क जो है नाफिज़ हो, इस पर अच्छी तरीके से डिस्कशंस हो, इसके इम्प्लीमेंटेशन के लिए वेज हम निकालें. इस दुआ के साथ हम इस इफ्तिताही इजलास का और कीनोट एड्रेस का इख्तिताम का ऐलान करते हैं. Here is a break for the lunch. सभी शुरुआत से दरख्वास्त है कि हमारे वॉलंटियर्स आपकी मदद करेंगे. आपको डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ एजुकेशन एंड ट्रेनिंग में लंच के लिए चलना है. उसके बाद दोपहर का सेशन CPDUMT के ऑडिटोरियम में, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ एजुकेशन से बहुत नज़दीक वो ऑडिटोरियम है. CPDUMT, सेंटर फॉर प्रोफेशनल डेवलपमेंट ऑफ उर्दू मीडियम टीचर्स, विच इज़ जस्ट एडजेसेंट टू डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ एजुकेशन एंड ट्रेनिंग, वहाँ पर दोपहर का सेशन होगा. दोपहर के सेशन में, जैसा कि आप जानते हैं, प्रोफेसर रामचंद्रन साहब और प्रोफेसर सुधाकर साहब हमारी गाइडेंस करेंगे. थैंक यू वेरी मच. प्लीज़.